So she is asking, your question is a state of an enlightened being. So enlightened being, he says, has no mind. Okay. So how does he work? How does he think? How does he act? So this no mind state, we should understand clearly. An enlightened state, an enlightened person is in a no mind state. Now this no mind doesn't mean that no thoughts. No mind and no thoughts are not same. Okay. Enlightened being has a thought. Enlightened being has a mind. But mind doesn't use him. He uses the mind when it's required. For thinking purpose, mind is required. But most of the people, they are not using the mind, but mind is using them. So you are driven by the mind. Whereas an enlightened being uses the mind appropriately. Then second thing is, he is spontaneous. When you say spontaneous, for a given situation, he responds. When you say response, the meaning is, depending on the situation, his actions can change. Whereas an unenlightened person reacts. The reaction is a programmed behavior. Okay? To give you an example, if you go behind the donkey is bound to kick you. Because donkey is programmed for kicking. Okay? Whereas in front of a human being, if somebody shouts, he has different responses. He may shout back, or he may calm down the other person, or he may go away. So there are different responses are possible. The flexibility is more in case of a human being. But most of the people, they react to a situation than respond. Okay. If somebody says something to them, suddenly they hurt and they react. In other words, human beings behave like a programmed machines very often. Sometimes they are okay. That means they are the program which is running is nothing but the mind. So you have become servant of the mind rather than the master of the mind. For a jnani or enlightened being, the mind also, let us say somebody shouts in front of jnani, a reaction may rise. But jnani is aware of the reaction rising, then he may react also, or he may not react also, depending on what is appropriate for the moment. But that's an action, not a reaction. It's a conscious action. This is one way. Second thing is, the no mind means, the mind is nothing but thoughts. Bundle of thoughts is called mind. Right? Mind is nothing but bundle of thoughts. Now these thoughts are nothing but objects, things. So the entire world is representation as thoughts in the mind. So for example, there is a fan. The fan is a thought in the mind. There is a clock. Clock is a thought in the mind. The world is nothing but a thought in the mind. Okay. Of all the thoughts, there is a root thought called I thought. The feeling of I. For example, the moment I see the fan, okay, I see the fan arises, the I thought arises and the fan arises. Two things will arise. That's called aham vritti and idam vritti. Aham means I, idam means that. So those two thoughts arise, aham vritti and idam vritti. Okay. Ajnani considers himself as aham vritti. He takes himself as the I thought. What he doesn't understand is that I thought, aham vritti and idam vritti both are appearing in consciousness. So he is really consciousness. That he doesn't understand. The I thought and this thought, object thought and subject thought both arise in consciousness. Okay. Ajnani considers I thought as me. Whereas Jnani considers as I thought also as an object. I thought is also not a subject. I thought is also object. He treats I thought also on par with the object. Like fan is separate from me. Like that he treats I thought is also separate from me. That means he is able to separate his subjectivity from the he becomes more objective. He is able to witness the body-mind complex operating. So his objectivity is more. He becomes more objective. Now I thought doesn't affect him now as much. Okay? If you see our problem in life is we constantly worry, oh, what's happening to me? Okay, this is happening to me. Somebody is trying to shoot me. Somebody is trying to hurt me. Okay, I have to go there. I have to do this. There, I is the law. Every time I thought comes, and I thought becomes a stressful thought, because ultimately I thought is the stress, right? Once you start understanding, I thought is not you, but I thought is an appearance in consciousness, just like another object thought. I is also an object, not a subject. But I am the subject, I am the witness, I am consciousness, whose nature is witness, bliss. Then what will happen? You are separating out yourself from the I thought. When you separate from I thought, the stress in life comes down. Because even somebody comes and tries to kill you, he is not killing you. You are the consciousness. So that clarity will be there. So now the effect of I thought on I thought will come down. I thought becomes weak. The I thought is called ego. A jnani also has an ego. Okay? For example, if you go and talk to Shri Krishna Paramatma, he will immediately turn around. Because he knows that Shri Krishna Paramatma is he is being addressed. So jnani also has an ego. Okay? Jnani uses the ego and ego doesn't use jnani. Okay? Most of the people think they are housewife, they are officer, they are employee, whatever roles they are playing, they become that. Whereas jnani very clearly knows these are the roles. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am the intellect. Okay? He knows that, but still he uses the ego appropriately. Okay? Whereas ajnani doesn't know. Ajnani confuses himself with the I thought and he gets driven by the ego, not by the consciousness. Right? So now, when I say no mind, actually no I thought. It is not that no I thought, it is that I thought has become object, not the subject. I am not the I thought. Okay, this is what happens in case of jnani. Without understanding this, people think that, oh, jnani means mind has to stop. So then they do a lot of different type of practices, like some type of breathing practice or whatever is there, to stop the mind. Okay, this is what is called in yoga chittavritti nirodha. Yoga chittavritti nirodha. That means mind has to be stopped to get jnana. That's what they think in yoga. I don't know whether all yogis think, but that's what they do. So that means mind has to be stopped, which is incorrect. Okay, mind need not be stopped. You have to understand the nature of the mind and become free from the mind. When you understand the nature of the mind, when you understand the nature of I thought, when you understand the nature of thoughts, you understand that I thought is an object, not a subject. That's actually no mind. So if somebody stops the mind, he almost becomes an idiot. Right? Mind is not working, then he can't function in the world. Jnani is very well able to function in the world because he knows how to use the mind properly. Right? Another aspect of this is when thoughts are not there, mind has become silent. You are in a state of samadhi. So jnani also can go into samadhi. Then there are no thoughts. And he can come out of samadhi and interact with the world. Okay? But for jnani, going into samadhi and coming back and interacting with the world are irrelevant. Because he is not the thought. Samadhi is also a state for him. Whereas for a person who doesn't understand this, samadhi is realization, which is false. Samadhi is a temporary state. Realization has nothing to do with samadhi. Realization is not necessarily samadhi waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, it is beyond all this state. I am consciousness, that understanding is there. If Jnani goes to come also, it doesn't matter. Jnani is actually working also, it doesn't matter, because you know he is aware that he is the consciousness. That is the state of a Jnani. And when you speak to a Jnani, okay, sir, can you, Swamiji, Mahatma, can you, will you eat food? If he say, yes, I will eat food. Okay. Then he eats food and he sits for Pravachana and then he says, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. I am consciousness. Now he said, I eat the food. Then you ask the question, how consciousness eats the food? Right? See here, when Jnani says, I eat the food, he says, he uses the I for the body, for your communication, because for you, you can understand that language. But even if he uses that, he is very clear, his consciousness, he is using it, transaction purpose. So here, in transaction purpose and transcendent, absolute purpose, absolute state, Jnani is not confused between the states, whereas Ajnani is totally confused. When we say no mind, it doesn't mean the mind doesn't stop, mind stops, no. It is the mind, ego has changed. So for Ajnani's ego, says I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Jnani's ego says I am consciousness. So that's the difference. So even when Jnani interacts, he will start use the word I like you. But his I means consciousness. But your I means body. That's the difference. This is a state of a no mind. No mind means not stopping the thoughts. If stopping the thoughts is Jnana, then thoughts will become a parallel reality to Atma. So Atma alone is real. Self alone is real, non-dual. The thoughts are not a parallel reality. It's mithya. So if you say thoughts have to stop, that means thought has become also satya, which is false, which is not true. So stopping of the thought is not Jnana. It may happen that in deep meditation, thoughts may stop. But no forcing of thoughts, forceful stopping of thought is required. So gradual understanding of thought and understanding the nature of the thought, thoughts are separated out from you and you are free. That's the state of no mind. Right? Did I answer your question? Yeah. Sure. I'll come. Yeah. There's a separate question?
One of the things you told that according to science, body will already act before we
can. Yeah.
So the mind is not really required, the action is anyway going to happen.
Yeah, so. It's a different question. So you are, there is a